Hello guys, welcome to our channel. The last video was about state flow basics, wherein we saw example of traffic signals and understand how to create a different states, how state transition from one state to another, and how to debug a state flow, along with how exactly state flow works. In this video, we will consider example of water tank to understand parallel execution of states, along with usage of symlink function and MATLAB function in state flow. So let's get started. So in this example, we are going to consider a water tank which has a two valves, one is for inlet and another is for outlet. The volume of water in tank is equal to existing volume plus inflow minus outflow. Basically, when valve one is open, then the water level in tank goes up, and when valve 2 is open, water level in tank goes down. So let's simulate this behavior using a state flow. I will quickly draw a state flow for this behavior. So we'll name our super state as water tank. In this we will have substate. Or tank fill. And empty. So in this particular model, we want fill and empty state to be executed in parallel. What that means is both these states will be executed on a single state. So to make it parallel execution, we need to go to decomposition and select parallel and. So we will see the dotted line for both the states which are executing in parallel. The number here shows the priority of the state which will execute first. Even though these will be run in a single step, the fill state will execute first and empty state will execute second. Let's add substate to fill. So here I will take valve 1 underscore close. Here we will consider valve 2 underscore close. We will add transition from these two steps. In both fill and empty, whenever valves are closed, we do not want anything to happen. But when valve is open, at that time we want tank volume to be incremented by flow rate. So here we will consider inflow rate. The same logic we can consider for valve 2. When valve 2 is open, we want tank volume to be decremented by outflow rate. So now adding the conditions. So when valve 1 is open, we want transition to valve open state, and when valve 1 is closed or tank volume is full, at that time we want transition to valve 1 close. Same thing for tank empty. Here we will consider valve 2 1. And then valve 2 0. tank volume less than or equal to 0. So if you want to write the condition to the next line, we can use three dots. Here instead of equal to 100, we can use greater than or equal to 100. So here we can add those variables or as data. You can consider vol1 and scope of this will be input, vol2 which is again an input, then tank volume which we want to consider as an output. Now inflow and outflow rate we can define constant here, but for the sake of simplicity and to calibrate our model in better way, we can consider inflow and outflow rate as input for state flow. Let's make outflow rate at 0.5. For now, let's first simulate our model and see if there are any errors present in our model or not. I want to run this model for 550 seconds. So I have created stop time as 550. These are fixed step discrete with fixed step sizes 1 second. So that is what we need. Let's try to simulate this model. So now only wall 1 is open. So ideally, if this model simulates well, we can see tank volume at 100. Yeah, so here we can see our tank volume has been saturated to 100. So our model is good. Same way here we can add. Our model is simulating fine. So let's see how to use MATLAB function and simulink function in state flow. So we will use each of these blocks for tank fill and tank empty just for demonstration purpose. So instead of writing conditions here, we can call function from states, and that particular function we can implement in either Simulink or MATLAB functions, which is a mscript. So the same logic which we have created in this particular state, we can create in a function. So for this we will use a MATLAB function, and we will use import 1 as tank volume, and import 2 as flow rate. We want to add these two value, you can give it to 100. And we will again output time volume. If you cannot use same name, you can use in and out for tank volume. We will name this function as tank fill. Now we need to call this function from the state where we want to use it. Since we have already taken care of saturation, we can directly call this function. And pass the required argument. So the first input is tank volume and the second is inflow rate. Similarly, we can use a MATLAB function so this MATLAB function will use for tank empty. So here we want tank volume underscore out equal to argument as tank volume and outflow rate. So if you want to saturate this between 0 to 100, so this will be our Simulink function for tank empty. So here we will call tank empty function and pass the required arguments to it. The saturation part, as in previous step, is already considered. So this should behave exactly same way to the earlier logic. Let's simulate and see if model gets simulated. So for inputs of Simulink function, we need to specify everything. It should not be inherit. Percentage or dimension is 1. Width size no. Signal type real. Same for this. Double. And flow rate is percentage per second. Or dimension is 1. variable signal size no, sample time is 1, and we are using real complexity. So we are getting the same output. Since this simulation is so fast, we cannot validate the behavior by manually changing the inputs. So we will use Signal Builder to provide inputs to this model and see if its behavior is exactly same as that of what we intend. So for that, I am using a Signal Builder where we can change the value of wall 1 and wall 2 either open or close, and based on that we will see the tank changes in tank volume. So we will get a Signal Builder and we will import a data com file, the signals, we want to replace existing data set. So this is our input data set, and let's add our log to the signals. Let's see the result. Here, even though wall 1 is open for more than 100 seconds, still the water tank is not filled completely, and also it is reducing at faster rate. That means there is mistake in our logic. Let's see that. So for wall 2, the logical operators are interchanged here. So here it should be and it should be OR. Let's simulate our model once again and now see the results. Yes, so this is the behavior which we want. So when wall 1 is open, at that time tank is getting filled. Once it reaches to 100, even though wall 1 is open, it cannot go beyond 100. When wall 1 is closed and wall 2 is open, at that time tank is emptying at relatively slower rate than the fill rate. When wall 2 is closed and wall 1 is open, tank is getting filled. When both walls are open, tank is getting filled at slower rate because wall 2 is also open. When wall 1 is closed, tank will again start emptying, and when both walls are closed, tank will retain its volume. That's it for today's video. If these videos are helping you, please like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.